Okay, great insights coming in from Abhay Lajewala there of Deutsche Bank. Let's touch base with KEI Industries. The case for chat here being strong performance in Q1, huge jump in turnkey projects, government spending on utilities, all of those are positive drivers. Anil Gupta, CMD of KEI Industries, joins us. Anil, good to have you on the show. Strong growth was seen on all parameters across all sectors. To start with, tell us about what led the growth on the turnkey projects business on the top line as well as the profitability side. Is it sustainable?
Yeah. As you know that we had been maintaining a very healthy order book positions since last year, and this has resulted into a very strong execution in the first quarter and also in the coming quarter, which is going on. So, hello?
We can hear you, Anil. Please carry on.
Yeah. So, this has resulted into a strong jump in the sales by around 38% compared to the same period of last year. And also, the resultant profits, which has been a net profit after tax, has jumped to 3.34%, around 27.5 crore in this first quarter, as compared to 11.2 crore in the first quarter of the same period last year. So the strong performance has come from all our business verticals. Our sales of cables has grown by 28%. Our sales from EPC contracts has grown by close to 100%. Our exports has grown. Export of cable has grown by 28% compared to similar period in the last financial year in the first quarter.
Tell me, what kind of volume growth are you currently witnessing, and do you think we can see a double-digit volume growth in the coming quarters as well?
We expect a volume growth and a resultant growth of close to 20% in this full financial year. That's a likely indication, and we hope to maintain it and sustain it. Similarly, in our turnkey projects, we hope to achieve a growth of around 50-60% over a full year period.
Okay. And what's been the retail contribution this time around?
Retail has grown by around 30%. The retail contribution in our sales of cables is around 227 crore, which is up by 30%. It was 175 crore in the first of the last financial year. So we have seen a strong growth in retail, and that has been our focus, which I said in my earlier interviews also.
Since you do plan to gradually increase your retail presence, tell us, what kind of margins do you enjoy? Also, export is also very high margin and huge potential. What kind of growth and revenue contribution can we expect from exports too?
Our margins in exports and retail at the moment are close to around 10% plus. And we hope that as our brand presence improves, we are spending a lot of, doing a lot of efforts on branding, in-shop brandings, below the line activities on branding, and as well as the media. So we expect that as our brand improves, brand performance improves, we will be able to improve our selling price as well. And that will lead to the improvement in the pricing. Pricing as well as the volume. I hope that we will be able to maintain a EBITDA of more than 10% in the whole financial year.
Right. And give us your sense on if you are looking at maintaining your EBITDA, what about the outlook for the revenue side? What kind of contribution do you see coming in from exports?
On a full year basis, I expect exports to grow by around 15% compared to the last financial year. In the last financial year, our total exports was around 380 crore rupees in the full year. And going forward, it may go up by 15-20%. This first quarter growth was around 28%. I'm always on a little bit on the conservative side in my guidance. Because we would like to do better on that. And retail will, I still maintain, will grow around 30% as a guidance.
Lastly, tell me, what's your EPC order book currently at and how do you expect it to grow? What's the pipeline looking like?
Our EPC order book at present is around 1800 crore and we have not pumped in much orders in last 6 months. So we have executed number of orders because our focus was more on not accumulating the order but on the execution. So I feel that in the coming months we will add some more orders. In few of the orders we are already L1 and we are just awaiting the placement of the orders.
All right, Anil, we wish you all the very best. Thanks so very much. Your earnings have evinced more interest in the stock and of course has led it to perform better for investors. So we wish you all the very best for the future as well. Appreciate your time today.
Thank you.
Okay, that's time out then. The market's holding out, holding up as well. So that's decent. Not too much really report in terms of a directional move just as yet. Maybe things would change through the course. We're just searching for our camera. Through the course of today's session. From Aisha and myself, thanks very much for watching First Trade. But news and updates continue on the channel. Stay tuned.